Can somebody tune in now, listeners?
107.5 WBLS. Welcome inside of the Quiet Storm. I'm Lenny Green, and that's a nice lead into Confessions of Love tonight. And I'm telling you, you're not going. Jennifer Holliday. We got company with us tonight. Tiffney Cambridge is the fiance of The Game. The Game. Of course, their show comes on VH1 every Monday night at 9:30. Phenomenal show. Congratulations once again on the success of the show.
Thank you.
And now you're in season two.
Right.
Can't wait to find out what unfolds this season. But right now, just to catch everybody up, you guys have been together for 8 years, and you have 2 children. And there was a wedding that was scheduled, and you postponed the wedding.
Yes.
Which is unusual, because normally the men would postpone it, but you postponed it because you felt that Jason wasn't ready to move forward into that. Did he say that to you as well?
No, his behavior did, though. A lot of times.
Well, can you explain that?
Sometimes, you know, you need to go by not what a person says, by what they do. So I wasn't looking at what he was saying. I was looking at how he was acting. So his behavior was not indicative of someone that was ready to walk down the aisle.
You know, that's a loaded statement right there, because I could take that in many different ways. When a person's not ready to walk down, so how do you know when a person is ready?
Well, for me, I just feel like you know that it's something that every woman just kind of knows. It's hard to explain, you know, something that you just kind of have to feel. And I think that he prepared to get married. I felt that he was ready in a lot of ways.
Okay.
But I just felt that he still needed to get some things out of his system. And I think he needed a deeper understanding of really what it means to be committed on that level.
Mm. Now, this would have been a first marriage for him and a first marriage for you as well?
Right.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Okay. And you guys have been together 8 years.
Mm-hmm. I think that he probably just thought, well, things will be just like they've been. We've been together for 8 years. We have 2 kids. So basically, I'm just tying the knot.
Have you guys went through any counseling on that?
We have gone through counseling.
Right, pre-marriage.
Something that I definitely think is very important for all couples to go through. I think you should go through marriage counseling, and sometimes you need to go through individual counseling as well. Sometimes we have individual issues that need to be addressed.
Right, because we could carry those individual issues into situations. So the question tonight, ladies and gentlemen, inside of Confessions of Love, and Tiffney is going to engage in the conversation with us, is should couples stay together for the sake of their children? What would you say?
I think it depends on the situation. I can't say yes.
If it's a bad situation? Because if it's a bad situation that the couple is going through, do you feel that the kids are going to be affected by that? Because I do. I think kids are going to be affected. Because kids are like, to me, children are like sponges.
Right.
So they kind of see, even though you may not communicate, they observe pretty quickly, no?
Right. I think in certain situations, if you are fighting and kids are seeing you fighting, they're seeing you arguing, they're seeing a lot of tension and a lot of unhappiness in the relationship, then it's not a good thing. But I also think that parents go through things. Parents are just two adults that have come together and had a family or made children, but adults argue. And I think that there's a lot to be said about resolving your issues as a couple, and kids really seeing that too.
Well, true, but a kid won't understand it to the level of the parents, obviously.
Right.
Tiffney Cambridge is with us tonight, the fiance of The Game. The Game, the rapper, yes, The Game. And you've seen her on Marrying The Game. So let's talk about it tonight. 1-855-453-6694. Join us online at WBLS.com. Click on the Quiet Storm page, and you can see us up close and personal, because we're going to continue the conversation online as well. Thank you for joining us online for The Quiet Storm Behind the Scenes. Tiffney Cambridge is with us tonight, and I thank you for coming in. She's a L.A. lady.
Yes.
Born and raised.
California girl.
California all the way. The ground is just so, sometimes, unstable.
Right.
But I guess you're accustomed to earthquakes or tremors.
Earthquakes. We've been having earthquakes since I was a little girl.
So it's nothing.
It's scary.
Still?
Yeah, it is. It is. You know, but, you know, I consider it a blessing to be in California. I mean, other places, we're not getting flooded. You know, we're not getting caught in a hurricane.
But you guys do go through a raining season.
Yeah, but it doesn't rain that bad.
Not anymore?
California, I think, is the state that has probably the best weather.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I do have family out in California, and much love going out to my family. I don't get a chance to see them often, but I do. It's a beautiful part of the country.
Yeah,
but my ongoing joke was California is going to have such a tremor one day, it's going to become its own state away from the United States. It's going to become its own state.
It would be in the Pacific Ocean.
Exactly. Tiffney Cambridge, of course, is the fiance of the game, and we love this guy's music. We loved it for years. But obviously, if you've been watching Marrying the Game on Monday nights at 9:30 on VH1, you know that they have been challenged, as we all are in life, with their relationship on a lot of different levels. And you're moving through it.
Yes, we are.
And that's a good thing. And I asked her a little while when we were off air. The children obviously plays a major role in all this. And the wonderful thing about Jason is that he's a dedicated father.
Yes, he is.
And you must love that.
Yes. I mean, to have him as involved in their lives as he is and being there since day one, mm-hmm. is really a blessing. I mean, even with his travel schedule and all the things that he's involved in, mm-hmm. he always makes time to go to all of their activities. He's at all of Justice's games and all of Callie's little ballet lessons. He loves the kids.
And that's important.
He's around.
He's involved. He's not even around.
He's around involved, for everything. Right? He's definitely involved.
And that's yeah, I love that, man. As I was telling you, you know, I commend men who really make it a point to do that.
Right.
Because it's so really, it's important for boys and it's so, obviously for girls as well.
Too.
Because it shapes them, you know, when they see positive men in their fathers, it shapes them and makes them become greater ladies. And you can relate that because you said you were daddy's little girl, right?
Yeah, you know, but recently my dad and I have fallen out. And, you know, just without getting too deep into it, I don't know. I think that my dad may be having some growing pains, some mental issues that I'm concerned about right now, because the distance that I've experienced with him within the last 2 years, it hasn't been. And he's just like on an island by himself, and being even grown and experiencing that disconnect with my father that I'm going through right now is really disheartening. So it's really a blessing to see that closeness between Callie and Jason, and how well connected and bonded they are.
Yeah,
it's important for Callie now, even just being three, because it's important. I miss the relationship with my father, and I'm grown. So.
Right, and you know that's important too, because but the nice thing about it is that you do have a long history of being close to your father.
Right.
So if there are other issues, I mean, obviously you probably are taking
care of that. Need to
address those.
Yeah.
And a lot of us, and when I say us, mean us black folks, sometimes we try to shun away from certain things. And I think some of us are getting to the realization that, you know, we are faced with certain challenges.
We have to address them. You know?
And we have to see those early signs.
Yeah. I think a lot of times people are embarrassed to talk about it.
Yeah.
You know, but The conversation definitely needs to be open.
I agree.
You know, black people need counseling.
We do. A lot of counseling sometimes. Tiffney Cambridge is her name. And she's with us tonight on Confessions of Love. Can we roll the tape at the same time so we can grab it at the same time? We got somebody on the line.
The children sense every kind of tension and animosity and distance in a relationship more than
hold
you
on,
give
hold on,
them.
Hold on, hold on, my love. I'm sorry. Let's get your name first.
Praise the Lord. My name is Tina Sam from Brooklyn, New York.
Hi, Tina. Say hello to Tiffney.
What?
Say hello to Tiffney Cambridge. Hello?
Praise the Lord. You're waking up.
Are you trying? You calling to answer the question, right?
Yeah, praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Didn't you understand that?
Oh.
Oh, yes, I
and
did.
I said
I got
that
you.
I agree with you on the fact that a marriage cannot work just on the sacrifice of the staying together for the sake of the children, because the children are like sponges, as you said, and they perceive things a lot more than we give them credit for. You understand what I'm saying? So when they're unhappy, then when you're unhappy, they're unhappy, no matter how you look at it, and their behavior demonstrates it, especially when they're away from home. And I don't know, Almighty, universal spirits, praise the Lord. And that's what I have to say. Good night.
Well, thank you and good night to you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is Confessions of Love, baby. We're inside the quiet storm. And I guess so. She's not definitely for a couple staying together if there is, just for the sake of the children. And you're right. I mean, at the end of the day, it does matter based on the situation that both of you go through. I just feel, though, in watching what my mom went through as a child, I'm very observant of that. And if she's going through any hardships in the course of something, the kid knows I couldn't evaluate it as a child because my, you know, intellect.
But you pick up on it.
Something is
especially
wrong.
Especially when the child is really connected with the mother the parent, or even with the father, you know. I think that is definitely true. The kids do pick up on it, and they do have a sense of unhappiness and happiness in relationships. And I don't necessarily think that you should stay and be unhappy. However, I don't think that you should throw in the towel that easily either. Well, when there's children involved, I think it's definitely worth the fight. Now, for myself, I've been able, because my kids are younger, to keep them away from any type of conflict that Jay and I may be having. Whether it's just not arguing in front of them. Sometimes we'll get into a heated discussion and I'll just let it go. You know, sometimes you have to be the bigger person and let the other one win.
Wow.
Just for the sake of the right. of the argument, so right. that I'm not arguing sure. in front of my kids.
Sure.
Because I don't want them to see that hostility, and I don't want them to see us going back and forth.
That
so I've had to do
that.
I've had to do that a lot.
Right.
But for us, we haven't gotten to the point where our relationship and the issues that we have been something that the children are really aware of.
Right.
Even with us doing the co-parenting thing, it's fun. They're none the wiser because they've always had the two home situation.
From
the jump, they've already had that.
So it's nothing unusual.
So there's right, nothing unusual right, for them. Right. But see, that's just my situation.
Right.
That's why it's you can't judge a person and what they're going through because you just never know what exactly is going on.
Tiffany Cambridge is her name, the fiance of the game. Jaycion. I'm sorry, Jaycion. Sorry, brother. But she's with us, and she's being open and very, very candid about, obviously, what's been happening with the show and in her personal life as well. Reality TV is something else for sure, and obviously you guys love it. Let's take another call. How are you tonight?
I'm fine.
What's your name?
My name is Dana Johnson.
Well, Dana, say hello to Tiffany Cambridge.
Hello, Tiffany.
Hi,
how
are
you this evening?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm blessed, darling.
That's good. I'm glad to hear that.
We're curious to know what your thoughts are on this topic tonight.
Well, with all due respect to you, Tiffany, I'm going to say something, and I hope by no means I'm trying to insult you. I think we as women, we are tolerant of a lot when we're in a relationship with a man. We go over the top to try to comfort him and try to be there for him. And sometimes in respect of that, we lose ourselves, which I think we should not do as people, you know. And if you keep waiting and you keep waiting and you keep waiting, when do you cut that off? You know, does it just keep going and keep going and keep going? You have to have a time in your life where you look at yourself, look at the relationship for what it's worth. And if it's not right, you have to walk away regardless to what may have be included while you're in that relationship, whether there's children there or it's just the two of you or whoever.
Right.
Sometimes you just got to go. You have to walk away.
Right. Yeah. I agree. I agree. Especially about the part of us tolerating a lot. You know, I think that's something that I'm guilty of tolerating. Think, you know, in a relationship, you try hard to make things work. What I can say about the time that I've spent in my relationship, I don't really feel like I've been waiting. per se, because I've been actively involved in my own individual progress as a woman, as a mother. So I haven't been sitting around per se waiting for anything. I think it was really important for me to have my kids. And so having them and really raising them has been a major part of our relationship. Justice is 6, and we've been together for 8 years now. So we've gotten, I would say, a lot accomplished in our time together. We've created a family. And so right now we're working on us. And I do think that it takes time. I do agree that, you know, you don't want things to go on forever and ever. But I can say that the time that I've spent in this relationship, I think, has been pretty well spent.
And you know what? I would like to just interject to say that you have a life.
Mm-hmm.
You, aside from the children,
right?
You have a life. You're developing yourself in great ways. And sometimes women don't do that,
mm-hmm.
or even the man won't do that. They just get caught up in everything,
mm-hmm.
as the young lady just stated, and they lose themselves,
mm-hmm.
and they get totally lost. But it seems like you're very focused in what you want to do, and obviously you wouldn't mind and love to do it
exactly.
collectively, but
exactly.
if not, you still have an agenda to definitely take
right.
care of. Hey, look, thank you for the call tonight, my love.
Okay, thank you very much.
Appreciate
and,
it.
Nice talking to you.
1-855-453-6694. Give us a call if you'd like to engage in conversation. This is Confessions of Love Behind the Scenes. I want to talk about your other ventures. You shared with us a little while ago that you do, well, you're an educator for one.
Right.
You've been in a school teacher for like 16 years, something like that?
16 years, yes.
So obviously you love children.
Yes, I do.
Now, did this come down from, like, was your mom a teacher? Your dad, was he a teacher? How did the education kind of filter into your DNA?
I've always had a love for children. When I was in high school, I would work at the YMCA, and I tutor at little preschools and was a teacher's aide and things like
okay.
that. But I really did not go to school to be a teacher. My degree is in sociology, which is the study of people, and I've always liked to be around people. I'm a good talker, good communicator.
That's good. That's
good. I'm a people person.
That's good.
I'm drawn to children. I like to mold them up and teach them. And then when that little light comes on and you really see that, that they get it,
yeah.
it's very inspiring. And so from the first day I started when I was really young, maybe 24 or something like that, when I went into my first class and I really saw that I could make a difference, I think that that's where my passion for education began.
Well, so... you've had a few graduates along the way.
Oh, yeah. I have kids that that contact me or email me or, you know, contact me through Instagram. And I look at their pictures and I'm like, wow.
Up so quickly.
My
yeah.
babies are grown because
yeah.
My kids are usually, when I start with them, they're 7 or 8.
Wow.
So I have kids that are 21 years old now. That see me and they're like, Miss Cambridge. So, yeah.
Well, it has to make you feel proud.
It does.
Are they continuing on with their education?
Yes, and they're doing really well, and I'm proud that I've been able to play that part in their lives.
You know what? You love what you do, and it reflects on your work that you see in them. And I think if anyone is passionate about something,
mm-hmm.
then it kind of shows its own self. And obviously, job well done, Miss Cambridge. Job
Thank
well
you.
Done. Tiffany Cambridge is her name. You can catch her every Monday night on VH1 9:30. If you missed it tonight, I guess obviously they do a lot of reruns, so you won't miss
it. It'll be on all night.
No question. I want to know the excitement that is coming in this season. I know you can't give up too many secrets,
right?
Obviously. But what is there going to be a devastating, like, oh, I can't believe that happened?
I think there'll be some what moments. Yes, I do think that. But you have to stay tuned in to see.
I just want to know why she got the cold feet. And I know you told me, but there has to be more than that.
Yeah.
And I want to delve a little bit deeper into that avenue, because when you said you kind of can just tell if a person he wasn't really ready to make that step. But he would have made the step
mm-hmm.
just because.
No, I think that he loves me and that he's very connected to our family. And I feel that he wanted and still wants to do the right thing.
But is
but this, JCI, well, I'll say Game is out of control. Well, and I don't want to sugarcoat it at all.
Okay.
I mean, people that know Game know how he gets down. He is not a little church boy.
I get
now,
that.
Now, I have, you know, got him to go to church.
Which is a good
and
thing.
And I got him baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. So I have done my part.
And
when
the walk is
heaven,
easy.
Jesus is saying, well
job
done, my good and faithful servant.
Come on up.
I did it.
Okay.
But at the same time, he's still Game.
He's, okay. He's, but
everybody knows how
him,
Game gets
But you
down.
Met him. You met him mm-hmm. when he was getting in the game.
I got with him before he was the game.
Okay, so.
So he was baby game.
Okay.
But now he's full-blown game.
All right, so you knew what was coming. You knew that there couldn't be too much of a transformation, not unless the person makes it themselves.
See, no, I did not approach my situation like that, and I think that's one of the biggest misconceptions about me and about our relationship.
Okay.
I did not get with Jason and really think, wow, you're getting ready to date a rapper. Jason and I got together when I was in a very vulnerable state. I had just lost my mother. So he came into my life and he was like a source of comfort for me. I was not thinking about the future. I was thinking about surviving the grief that I was going through at that particular moment. I liken it to drowning. You know, when I lost my mother, she's the closest thing to me. She's my very best friend. So I felt as though at that time of my life, I was drowning. And if you think about it in terms of that, if you're out to sea and you're drowning, you're not looking at the life vest or
right.
the
you're
boat.
Just trying to,
you're just trying to, you grabbing on to
sure.
whatever.
Right.
And for me, Jason Young was that person for me. He was there.
Anchor. He was that rock for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was there for me. Kind of distracted my mind away from what I was going through. And our relationship really developed out of a friendship. So I didn't take the time to really think about what my life would be like if he blew up and he became this phenomenon that he is.
Right, but you knew his passion, just
right.
like you know your
passion.
I knew
that he wanted to break into this game. But see, with Jason, he's multi-talented. He just really got up one morning and said, I'm going to be a rapper, literally. He did not all his life want to rap. He was getting into trouble. He got shot. And he knew that he had to turn his life around and get out the streets.
In order to survive.
And because his father is very poetic. He's a very good writer. And his mother is very intelligent, too, and she has a hustler mentality. She's good at a lot of different things. She's good at making money and moving fast. And I think that the combination of those two personalities gave him the personality that he has.
Sure, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
No. So he got into the game really quickly.
Right.
And Jason Young blew up overnight. He really did.
And then in the midst of his career,
we were trying to have a relationship.
Well, yeah. And that's hard, too.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard. And even if you don't blow up overnight, you know, just trying to have a relationship and you're trying to get to that level is so hard. And you really need a person to be understanding, to be flexible, to be there for comfort and support as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I understand that struggle. But in the midst of it all, we find that he is very good at acting because
mm-hmm.
he's done some wonderful work in natural too.
And I'm trying to get him to do voiceovers. I think that he has a very distinct voice that is easily recognized. He can change it up a lot. So I'm trying to tell him, if you don't want to sit in front of the camera all the time, sit behind the camera. Do voiceovers.
Really, yeah.
Really get into film.
And brother, there's a lot of money in that arena. Mm-hmm. If you really get into it, it's a lot of money.
Listen to your sexy voice. You see?
Yeah, but I don't have that extra gig, you know what I'm saying? Because I get stereotyped, you know, with the voice.
Uh-huh.
You know, you get stereotyped. But and they kind of just put you in one category. But I do know there is a wonderful career in voiceover work. Wonderful career. Tiffney Cambridge is her name, and you're going to learn a lot more about her in this season two of Marrying the Game. Is there a wedding that happens at the end of it all?
Are you asking me?
I'm asking you, yes.
You have to watch and see. I can't give away our ending.
Okay, all right. Let's go back on air. Thank you for joining us. 1-855-453-6694 if you'd like to join us. Welcome inside the Quiet Storm, baby. This is Lenny Green, and we are inside of Confessions of Love. We have Tiffney Cambridge with us tonight. She's the fiance of Jaycion. Jaycion, otherwise known by many as The Game. Yes, Marrying the Game is their hit reality show. What encouraged both of you guys to want to bring cameras into your life?
Well, actually,
because your life is really exposed to a small degree anyway, but yes, bringing cameras into the life brings it to a whole new different level.
It does. When we first started out, we were just going to document the wedding. Okay. So I actually just signed up for a wedding series.
Oh.
And when I postponed the wedding, it spun into Marrying the Game.
Oh, okay.
So that's how, oh, wow, that's how it happened.
But he was down.
We're going to document our wedding. And I was going to show everybody my big, beautiful ceremony.
Okay, okay.
And then, like I say in the introduction, life and the game got in the way. It's really true. And Marrying the Game series actually evolved after I postponed it. People were really interested in why I did that. And the whole dynamics of our relationship, and being a rapper, and me being a school teacher, and
that's
how
two,
we balance that.
Yeah, that's two different,
totally
different worlds.
Right, right.
Oh, that's crazy. Tiffney Cambridge, that's her name tonight, and that's her name. And she's with us tonight inside of Confessions of Love. You, as we mentioned online, for those of you who did not get a chance to go online to listen to the conversation, Tiffney has been an educator for 16 years, and her relationship with The Game has been with a mighty long time. It's 8 years, and that's a healthy time. Like, I've talked to couples that have been together 20 years, and they still have no formal commitment, and I'm scratching my head because I'm like, what is too long? There has to be an expiration. There has to be a cutoff because, I mean, you said you're fine either way. You're fine, and we don't know. We won't know until the end if there's going to be the wedding. But if the wedding doesn't happen, you're cool with that because of the children. I asked you a little earlier, well, what about if the kids were not there? Would things be greatly different?
I think that things probably would be. I think that the kids over the years have been the glue that have kept us together. I think that we both really do want for the kids and for us to be a family. My mother and father and Jay's mother and father separated when we were young. Yep. We both love our kids and we want to give them the opportunity to have a mom and a dad together in a home. And so I do think that we try, and we've tried for a longer period of time than maybe we would have if we didn't have them.
Right.
To really make it work.
Yeah, you know, kids are magical in that regard because they do hold the substance. And it's wonderful that, you know, these two beautiful children have both of you, because y'all understand the importance of that. And we want to see more black families. I think, you know, our present president right now is a wonderful reflection,
wonderful
of what good family structure is all about as well. I mean, we don't know what goes on in the White House, but, you know, we see the images, and the
good,
images
and
looks
it feels
great.
Good,
it does.
And it seems right.
It does. It really does. Aside from your personal life, I want to delve into your advocacy for breast cancer.
Right.
Why did that attract you, and why are you an advocate for breast cancer?
My mother passed from breast cancer, as did my mother's mother, my maternal grandmother. Mm. And I've had several people in my family pass away from breast cancer. I have an aunt, it's just like a sister to my mother. She has a breast cancer foundation. It's the Denise Roberts Breast Cancer Foundation, and we support minority women that are fighting breast cancer, who are underprivileged, who live in communities where they can't go and get a mammogram. They can't, they don't know how to check their breasts for lumps. And so, you know, I'm really, really trying to get out into the community and promote breast cancer awareness. And I'm really, really fighting for a cure.
Yeah, and it's been going on way too long. Way too long. Tiffney Cambridge is with us tonight. 1-855-453-6694. This is Confessions of Love. If you ladies can relate to her story, her personal story, on any level, give us a call. Let's talk about it tonight. Join us online too at WBLS.com. Click on The Quiet Storm and let's talk about some things tonight. Here's something brand new from Robert Glasper with the help of Jill Scott. It's called Calls. Just keep an eye out. Thank you for joining us behind the scenes of The Quiet Storm. Breast cancer is not only affecting women. It's, I understand, it's even affecting men.
Yes, it is.
We don't pay attention to it, and I often encourage ladies to pull their, you know, their better halves to the doctor, because obviously, you know, we don't like to do the doctor thing
right.
either. But so for that awareness, because it is a devastating disease that's really affecting a lot of minority communities.
Yeah,
at
early detection, you know, really does save lives. If you can catch those tumors before they start spreading
right.
into the lymph node areas and into other parts of a woman's body, you can really have treatment and live. I have a girlfriend named Kristen. 36 years old, just had a double mastectomy.
Mm.
So it's hitting women in our community at younger ages.
Is it diets? Have you? Because I'm sure you've done the research. Is it solely diets that is causing this?
You know, I definitely advocate healthy eating and healthy lifestyles.
Right.
And, but you never can say. You know, sometimes I think that you're born with it, that you just have.
Well, we do
genes,
have cancer cells, right,
yes,
in our body.
That those genes just are there.
Right.
You know, I'm struggling with right now getting that marker test, you know, that will let me know if I'm more likely to get cancer than not. My doctor has recommended it several times for me. My younger sister has had the test, or is getting set up to have the test. But it's just so... It's so nervous.
I know.
It's an unnerving thing, but it's something that I do think that I need to do and that I'm going to do.
Yeah.
It's next month, October. Next month, September. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
And do you do a big event out in California?
Yes, we do marathons. We have health fairs and health clinics. We really try to get into the smaller minority communities and really promote awareness of breast cancer, teaching women how to really examine their breasts, and you know the necessity to go and have a mammogram.
Yeah, because my auntie had double mastectomy as well, but they caught it in time.
Mm-hmm.
But even though she transitioned already, but it really is important, and it's just about going to the doctor. It doesn't require a lot, but it does take. You do have to make that initial step.
You know, you need to. Have your prostate checked.
Yep.
You know, you guys don't want to put the kahunas on the table.
Well, you know,
easy. You need to get the kahunas.
Tiffany. I understand something. You know, if
put
a guy
them down on the table and get them smashed.
Whoa, Tiffany, easy.
The same way we
those
do,
are gentle.
Okay?
Those are gentle things that we have, right? Gentle. They're very gentle. You can't do it the same way as a breast. Not at all. So don't. You can't do that. However, I will encourage the men definitely.
The process. Whoa.
You're so. I'm glad you're not a doctor. I'm really glad you're
put
not
your
a
balls
medical doctor.
Down and get them checked out.
Jesus. Well, yes, you got to get it checked out, fellas. And you know what? There's two different ways. You got to get obviously. The finger,
mm-hmm.
but they do have the blood test now,
mm-hmm.
which is called a PSA. So you could do it either way, and sometimes the blood test is a good gauge as well. But if your doctor is really thorough, he'll want to do the finger thing,
mm-hmm.
and it's a very unpleasant
yeah,
situation.
Yeah, but see, you know, men, you know, you guys think if the front part works, you know, that's all you need.
You're right. You're pretty much. And look, that's the main thing.
If you want your front part to work, you better check out the back part.
You know what? I'm going to give you up top on that, except I'm not going to give her up top on the smashing and put it up on the table kind of thing, because, you know, something tells me you would be a rough doctor. Come on, put your balls up on the table.
Yes,
you know,
let's get them checked out. Let's go.
Oh, that's too crazy. Tiffany Cambridge is her name, an advocate for breast cancer, and that's good to know. That it really is. And a writer in the making. Your children's series book should be coming out in 2014.
Yes. I
what kind of
was
books?
Going over one of the kids in my classroom. I was going over a cumulative file that we all as teachers fill out at the end of the school year. And I noticed that this little girl that was in my class started out in kindergarten with this big, beautiful smile, right? But as she progressed through school, she lost it. It seems like each grade, her smile just dimmed and dimmed and dimmed and dimmed. By that time she got to fifth grade, she wasn't smiling at all. She had like a blank, empty stare on her face. Mm. So I talked with her, and I talked to the school counselor and with her parents, and really found out her story and how her early childhood experiences really took her smile away. Her parents got divorced, so she was staying with a grandmother, and she was being teased because she wasn't able to live the same lifestyle that she was able to live with her parents. She went through a lot of emotional pain and turmoil. And this little girl that started out with this big, beautiful smile and this happy spirit turned into this sad child. It got me thinking. And I came up with a series called How the Little Girl Lost Her Smile.
Wow.
It's about a little girl who lost her smile, going through things that children go through. But by the end of the story, she got her smile back.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm working
on. That's really deep.
Yeah.
And now, this book would be for adults or?
No, it's going to be for kids.
For kids, okay.
Age about 7 to 13. But adults can read them too. I always read children's books to my kids. Mm. Like when I taught fifth grade, for example, the kids are older. But you can go get a book like The Little Engine That Could, and you can read that to older kids. It means something different when you get older. The moral is there, though, the teachable moment is there in the story.
Gotcha.
So I'm writing the they're small children picture books, and my target age is right about 7 to 13. But I think, you know, they're books that all kids could read and enjoy, and even as adults could understand.
Are you well read? Like, do you make it a point to read often?
Yes, I read. But you know what I've been reading lately? The Bible.
That's a great book.
I've been reading the Bible. I've been reading Psalms.
Wow.
A lot of Psalms. I've been trying to keep myself uplifted.
Well, I understand. And how's it going so far?
Good. You know, I try to get up in the morning and go to a scripture and just read, meditate.
What church do you go to?
I go to the City of Refuge, Bishop Noel Jones.
Oh.
Back at home.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes. Wonderful teacher.
Uh-huh, he is.
Yes, wonderful. I love watching him deliver the message.
Yes.
Because he delivers the message.
That's
in a great
my bishop.
Way. Yeah, mm-hmm. Noel Jones. Wonderful, wonderful. Tiffney Cambridge is her name, doing some wonderful things. And, of course, forging ahead in this relationship situation, as we all do. A lot of people don't understand that with a relationship comes work. Mm-hmm. They think a relationship comes like it's just magical, but it's really work. We'll go back on air and talk with Tiffney. And again, 1-855-453-6694. Call us up. .5 WBLS. Welcome inside the Quiet Storm. We're joined tonight by Miss Tiffney Cambridge. Tiffney, of course, is the fiance of the renowned rapper The Game, and their show is phenomenal. It's on VH1 every Monday night at 9:30, called Marrying the Game. I can't wait to see how season 2 is going to pan out. You guys have made VH1 very, very proud because you set records for VH1 in terms of reality shows, and that's a wonderful thing. The challenge in reality shows is, I would think, exposing your personal life and letting everybody know, because now I'm sure all the students in your school, at least their parents, know about your business and what's going on. So I guess you don't have any, well, I'm sure you have some kind of waves and cutoff moments, but it must be kind of difficult just allowing yourself to be transparent like that to everyone.
It is, especially for me. I think Jason is used to it.
Mm-hmm.
He's been out a long time, mm-hmm. so he's kind of used to being exposed in that way.
But the children now,
for even, me, it's a different, and with Callie and Justice being so exposed, it's a challenge.
Yeah. But, you know, it seems to me like aside from your, you know, you're doing the teaching and you're writing the books, it seems like you're coming into a full blossom moment yourself.
I know.
So we got to watch out for you now.
I know.
Get ready.
It kind of happened overnight. It wasn't expected. I'm learning on the job, and I'm trying to do the very best I can with it all.
Now, how does he deal with that? Because, you know, here we have a beautiful school teacher that's not doing anything, you know, on the worldwide web. Now things are 360 degrees difference for you. So how does he deal with your fame, or how does he deal with the fact that you're getting, you know, a lot of attention?
I think he's proud of me. I really do. I think that he's proud of the woman that I am and the mother that I am to the children. And I think that he's proud that everyone is able to really see what he's seen for all these years.
And what is he seeing?
I think JCI really enjoys the stability that I provide. And I have good sense. I really do. I it's one thing to have book sense, and then there's another thing to have common sense and just good sense.
Well, that means you come from good parents.
I do, and I come from good stock. And I was raised well, was blessed enough to be raised in a really supportive family. We encourage each other, and we're there for each other. We love each other. And I'm able to show Jason that and to give him the type of family life and the type of stability that he's always wanted. He had a tough upbringing.
Hey, look, you know.
So now to be able to step into his own and have his own family.
Right. Means a lot.
Means a lot.
Well, this has been a wonderful experience for me to sit down with you. I think what I really wanted to sit down and have a conversation once I realized that you were doing so many other things. The breast cancer thing is a great thing. Your children's book is another thing. And then I wanted to understand the reason why, you know, you called off the wedding. Mm-hmm. And I thank you for coming in to just share that with us. I can't wait to see how the rest of this season, like I said, unfolds, because I know it's going to be pretty interesting as we go down the pipe.
Yes.
How can everyone just stay in contact and connected to you?
Well, I'm on Twitter and on Instagram. My name is Love Tiffney.
Can I get a follow?
Yeah, you can get a follow.
Please.
Get a follow.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
No, I'm Love Tiffney. My name is spelled T-I-F-F-N-E-Y. So it's Love Tiffney on Twitter and on Instagram.
Got it. Okay. Well, we will keep up with you.
All right.
We know that you post up a lot.
Yeah, I try to stay relevant.
I'm sure you won't have a hard time doing that. Tiffney Cambridge, what a pleasure and an honor.
Thank you.
We wish you all
much.
The best. Please give
thank
our
you,
love.
Thank you, New York, for having me.
Hey.
Had a wonderful time.
Anytime. Anytime you're on this side of the world where it doesn't shake and move so much, you're more than welcome to come in and sit down with us.
Okay.
Please all give right. JC on our love and our respect,
will.
Okay?
I will.
Tiffney Cambridge, inside the Quiet Storm tonight. 107.5 WBLS.
For you, I'd give a lifetime of stability. Anything you want of me, nothing is impossible. For you, there are no words or ways to show my love. Cause this life is no good alone. Since we've become one, I made a change, and everything I do now makes sense. All roads end, all I do is for you. Share the cup of love that overflows, and anyone who knows us knows I would change all thoughts I have for you. There is no low or high or in between of my heart that you haven't seen. Cause I share all to understand. Life is no good alone. Since we